Creating a spacecraft is a process. Engineers conceptualize, model, and predict the performance of a vehicle using computers and other development tools. Eventually, the design is put to the test in the real world, but not all at once. Rather than launch an entire vehicle, components are tested one piece at a time before being brought together in an integrated flight test. It's a tried and true method called test as you go.
It's so important as you're doing your design to do early checks to validate your fundamental assumptions. It's cheaper to test these individual things by themselves before they're part of an integrated system. So an integrated system, if failed during flight, it'd be much more expensive. So you want to break it down into pieces.
Engineers would rather discover a design flaw on a test stand instead of during a flight. The end goal of using the method is to build a safer vehicle.
Certainly before the crew is launched for the first time, the intent would be to do a really good thorough wringing out of all of the systems to understand that we've closed or bought down any of the risk that are involved with the flight of the vehicle prior to putting humans on.
The space shuttle was the only spacecraft launched as a complete system without flying an unmanned test first. The integrated flight included detaching solid rocket boosters, a detaching external tank, a return through the Earth's atmosphere, and unpowered landing from orbit, all of which were tested for the first time with a crew on board. For Constellation, the spacecraft will see a return to unmanned flight tests.